You're listening to Teresa's Garage Radio Show with your host, Teresa Aquila. Teresa is a local mechanic who works on everything from high-performance hot rods to heavy equipment. Teresa's Garage Radio Show is broadcast weekly as a production of America Matters Media. Call toll-free worldwide at 844-790-TALK. That's 844-790-8255. And now, here's your host, Teresa Aquila.
Welcome, everyone, and happy Halloween. Yes, it's that lovely day where everybody gets to dress up and look like somebody else on this beautiful Tuesday.
Even you.
Even me, right? Thanks for joining us, and I am your host, Teresa Aquila. And coming up on today's show, we've got a great show for you today because we got Dan McGee from NVRacingNews.com in the studio, and then live from Las Vegas, that car chick herself, Jeanette DesJardins. She's down in the SEMA show, and we're going to have her on the show here shortly. But we want to let you know that we come to you live from the Reno Town Mall, just south of the biggest little city, Reno, Nevada. And I always start off the show with, what is grinding my gears? And Dan, I don't know about you, but
what is it today? What,
it's always, you know, Rosanna, Dana used to say, it's always something, if anybody of you remember Gilda Radner. Tailgating.
Ah, yes.
God, I hate tailgaters. And I'll tell you what, these people, I don't know what it is, but every morning coming from the North Valleys, I mean, it's bad enough. It's two-lane traffic, and they got like, you know, 50,000 homes out there, and so you're all bottlenecked. And these people, they think if they, like, get right up to your tailpipe, that you're going to, you know, move over for them. The only problem is there's nowhere to go. And then there's the ones who drive fast and then slam on their brakes to get up to you and then try to intimidate you. What do you do when you get a tailgater, Dan?
I ignore them.
Yeah, just turn up the rearview mirror so you can't see them.
Occasionally a gentle tap on the brakes, you know.
Oh, yeah, Now, don't be causing road rage. That can be considered road rage if you're, you know, trying to do that. But, you know, where's everybody going to go? I had one the other day. I swear to goodness, I'm doing 70 in a 65.
I know I was speeding. Crushed.
I know I was speeding. But I'm going faster than the number two lane, which is the slow lane. And these people got right up behind me. And when there was an opening between the car next to me, or, you know, the lane next to me, they would zip over like maybe they could squeeze between us, and there's no room. And then they jump back and cut people off. And I had that happen to me a few years ago where I always keep a distance between me and the car in front. I try to.
Attempt.
And I keep attempting, and they keep squeezing in there. Well, this one guy, and thank goodness I had a highway patrolman two cars behind me, saw the whole thing. And this car comes up, cuts in front of me, and then all of a sudden the vehicle that I was keeping my distance from slams on the brake. Because, you know, around here, and I'm sure those of you listening, you probably have the same thing, where everybody kind of goes, all of a sudden you're really going slow, and then all of a sudden you go 40, and then instant stop.
Back to 20.
Well, no, it's like almost a stop. Well, that's what was happening. And that car that cut me off, I end up hitting.
Oh.
And the law reads, if you hit the vehicle in front of you, it's your fault. Well, the highway patrolman behind me saw the whole thing, and the guy cut us off, slammed on the brakes, and then I hit him. And so, yep, we had to pull off the highway, of course, and then that slowed traffic even more because the looky-loos, you know,
they want to
make sure that, you know, they're not going to take me out of the car and slam me to the ground or the other way around. you never know. But they, you know, the driver of the car is like, well, she hit me, and the highway patrolman's like, really? Well, I was two cars behind her, and you cut her off. She kept a good distance. You're the one at fault.
Ooh, very good.
Oh, you know, sometimes karma, you get to see it.
How hard was it not to laugh right then?
Oh, I wasn't laughing. I was mad.
I bet you were.
Oh, my God. It didn't do much damage to my car or my truck because I sat up higher. My bumper got it more than the you know, kind of smooshed in. The trunk looked like a little pug nose because the car was so low. But Ah, my God, it just drives me crazy. And when I was coming into the station today, here I am, fast. I'm in the fast lane doing about
doing six. Speed limit, right?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah, you ought to see me when I drive from Reno to Vegas. Always the speed limit. Always, always.
I think it's 95 now, isn't it? Or maybe that's highway now.
Well, when nobody's looking, it is. Well, you know, if you've ever driven, for those of you listening, if you've ever driven from Reno to Las Vegas, there's a whole lot of nothing for 8 hours.
You
have a town here and there, but that's it. But you do have open range, and I actually hit a bull just coming outside of Tonopah one time, and I'm going to tell you.
Didn't hurt the car, did it?
You know, it did. Thank God I had a chrome brush guard on the front of my truck, and this is when I was working for entertainers, and I was coming back from Vegas after a gig down there, and I had a friend with me. And my friend turned out to be one of those basket case kind of people. When you're having a trauma, they're more trauma than the trauma you just incurred. It's like, oh my God, it's 8:00, 8:30 at night, because I had my CB radio, if anybody even knows what those are. Mm-hmm. And a trucker was going by because he ran it over after I hit it. And you couldn't see it until it was right, you know how it is out there.
Yeah,
there's no light.
They don't put reflectors on them. It's really bad.
I know. You know, have you seen those Halloween little things you put on your arm? Maybe we should start giving them to those guys, right? And you have to pay. Yeah, I had to pay like 6 cents on the hoof or something. I forget what it was. Well, the insurance company paid for it. But, you just have to be careful driving out there.
So the basket case person will never ride with you again?
No. They were freaking out. I had flares. And thank God that a trucker went into Tonopah and said, hey, you know, you've got an accident just, 15 miles out of town. And they showed up. And, my friend's all panicking and thinking we're going to be stuck out there forever and attacked by the zombies or something. It was like, oh, my God.
That's when you entertain them with ghost stories about the part of the world.
Never drove with that person again, I can tell you. Anyway, we're going into our first commercial break. When we come back, it's going to be Dan McGee from NVRacingNews.com giving us all those updates. And then my special guest, Jeanette DesJardins, Ms. Car Chix herself, live from SEMA in Las Vegas. So don't go away.